Ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to speak about something that is very important to our life. They call it Efrat. Hopefully until the end of the class, Efrat model. Hopefully until the end of the class we will be successful with God's help to explain each part of this word in Hebrew and in English, what is Efrat it's all about. First of all, I saw a beautiful, beautiful explanation to overcome one of the most difficult characters in our life. If you're going to ask me, one of the worst character that you can have. Listen to this. Which character is one of the worst character to have? Which character, if you have it, you don't have to be cursed. You live in hell and 120 years. Nobody have to curse you. You are a walking curse. Lo anin velo lechem. Which character you have to make sure that your spouse, man or wife, doesn't have? You're going out on a date and you're checking who's going to be your future wife. Which character you have to be so careful? Stinginess, anger. Listen to this. One of the worst characters that is so difficult to overcome is jealousy. Akinah Yosef motzia et ha'adam min ha'olam. Jealousy take you out from this life. You buy a coat, a beautiful coat. Suddenly your friend bought a better coat. Your friend invite me. I mean, if you bought Musnakel and he bought Makash. Ish, America, America. Deep down you tell them, wow. But the only thing that you have in your heart, how come you have a better coat for me? I wish that this coat is going to be ripping. I wish it's going to have something. Jealousy can lead us to do the worst things ever. The reason that the first killing in the history happening is because Cain jealous in heaven. One brother is jealous in another one. You know how bad is jealousy in relationship-wise? In life, you will never enjoy anything you have. You just bought a new phone, and your friend have a better phone. You bought a new shoes, and somebody in the yeshiva came with the better shoes. Simple items. You came and you say Chiddush Torah, and a minute later, another rabbi came, and he made a speech, and wow. Why him and not me? Why? This is the only reason that we cannot enjoy. Listen to what the Peleoets write. What is jealousy it's all about? He said, what's the reason that people is jealous? Because people like to believe and like to feel that he is the only one that exists. And he is the smartest one. And he is the most beautiful one. And he is the most talented one. It's all about me, I, me, and myself. And suddenly somebody else exists and maybe is even better from you in the yeshiva. Much better. Maybe he's even more good looking from you. Maybe he's driving a better car. Maybe he got married and you not. Maybe he have children and you not. Maybe he bought a brand new house and you not. And you sitting down at home and you feel that pain of jealousy. And what do you see? What do you do? Listen to how far jealousy can lead. You pray to God. God made something bad. I wish that the IRS will go in to visit him. I wish that the building department will put stop orders. I wish that his business is going to go wrong. All what you praying is not for your success. It's for the damage of others. I wish, God forbid, that you're going to have crisis and he shalom bites. Do you know that something like that? I believe that Bukharian mothers is one with Moroccan mothers or any Arabic Jewish mothers. They always told us, when you get a salary from a good eyes person, when you get a gift from a good person, take the gift. It's a blessing and the gift. But if somebody give you a salary, even a salary, when somebody give you a gift and you have a bad eyes on you, don't touch the gift. Don't touch. Somebody give you brand new shoes and you can see that he has such a bad eyes. I don't know what's going to happen when you're going to walk with these shoes. You can make accident, you can sleep, who know what. Don't touch something with the bad eyes. Evil eyes come from jealousy. Jealousy. Lashon hara come from jealousy. All the bad things come from jealousy. And how did the Shlach HaKadosh write? Kol yamav machovim. All his life is one big suffering. You know how nice it is not to be jealous. Your life is amazing. Dr. Daniel, is anything better not to be jealous? You see, Dr. Albert, and instead, you say, Dr. Albert, I love you, Kapar, you are my partner, I want to see. And Dr. Albert's vice versa, he see you being new and moving into Jamaica mistake, I don't know which mistake you did, but you're moving out, and you see, Baruch Hashem is so happy for you. Do you see that? How many of us are really happy with our friend's success? Somebody gave answer in the yeshiva, and Daniel, the answer was ash. The Rosh Hashiva looked at him and said, wow, are you happy for these friends? Or you feel, why not me? Why not me? Why I cannot be that star? Listen to this. What exactly we have to do to overcome this character that's called jealousy? Esther, the Shlach HaKadosh writes, three different gifts, advice. The first one is, remember Rachel Rachel, en Adam nogea b'chavero, b'ma sh'magia l'chavero, afilu kemelon ima. No one can touch what belongs to you. This is the first fundamental rule in Judaism. If these shoes was belong to you, nobody can cancel it. If this shidduch will belong to you, nobody can touch it. This wife, this husband, will be yours. If not now, a little later, but it's going to be yours. No one can touch what belongs to you. We're jealous because we're thinking that is in our expense. You know why nobody have anything in your expense. This is what belongs to him. And what belong to you precisely. You're not going to make a penny more and a penny less. Even if you have three different competition, I remember that I saw here a dentist stores that open, and being a rabbi for my own children, Dr. Daniel and Dr. Albert, I felt bad. Honestly speaking, I felt so bad, not that I care. But I came to Dr. Albert, I said, Dr. Albert, why these guys open competition? I don't understand what exactly happened. You're my sons. I'm praying all day long. Said Rabbi Vaklin, you have nothing to worry. No one can touch what belongs to us. Our customer will remain our customer. What a fate, huh? What a fate. Imagine as if you go into this guy that open and you give him bonbonera chocolate and a flower and say, thank you very much. Any advice, any help, we are here. Don't call us, we call you. We're gonna call you any advice you need, any machine, any camera, just call us. Imagine as if going into your competition and come with this attitude. You see, what's the problem? I had the privilege one time in my life to do something that in a normal way, he looked completely not normal. I was dating a woman twice. I'm sorry, I'm happy to share personal stories because you're the only crowd that I can feel comfortable at home. I'm not gonna share it with any other crowd. The story is not comfortable. I took this woman to the Western Wall to propose. To propose her to be my wife. And on the way, when I'm driving driving on the way to the hotel from Bnei Brak, she told me that I'm not the one. Why? Why? Dr. Daniel, you still we have a problem. Why? What do you do in this moment? For 1 hour he was silent, and you know me, I love talking. No. We continue to the hotel. We pray. And on the way back, Dr. Mikhaili was such a silent, you can cut it with a knife. Usually, being a rabbi, you love talking. And it was very rare to see me so quiet. What exactly you can say, you know? She's the only one that caused the 2 dates. The 2 day rule. The next one was my wife. The only one that caused the 2 dates was this woman. That I'm going to the Western Wall, what a better place, to propose. And what did you tell me on the way? You're not the one. Why? Emmanuel, what a life. You know what I did after? Because I got to know her so well, 24 hours later, I called my friend, one of my best friends from the yeshiva. I told them, I have a great news for you. I got to know your wife. I gave him her phone number. I sent a message. I gave her his phone number, and they got married. Wow. How many of us had the ability and the zchut and the privilege? Now, don't think that it was easy, but I realized that this is such a gift. What belongs to you, nobody can take. And what doesn't belong to you will never be yours. So why do you care to help another one to get married? Ay, ay, ay. Do you hear that? Jonathan, do you hear that? Jealousy is because we believe that we can conquer something by force. I can force it. You cannot force anything. Why do you need to sweat and bother? If this is not yours, it's not yours. And if it's not yours, why do you care to help somebody else? The customer that didn't show up in your place is not your customer. His name didn't say Dr. Albert or Dr. Daniel. His name said different doctors. And the customer that belongs to you, they wake up in the morning and the only place that they know is the best dentist in the whole 5 boroughs, Dr. Daniel and Dr. Albert, yes. Rabbi Vaklin and I approve this message. Sponsored by the BJCC Youth Minyan Third Floor. The place to be, exactly. No, this is a commercial moment. Ladies and gentlemen, Yosef, to overcome jealousy is to remember that nobody can touch what belongs to you. In other ways, the Shlach HaKadoshai, the second way, is to remember that we are one soul and one body. And if this is was your brother, are you going to be happy for him, yes or not? Obviously, you're going to be happy, right? Obvious that you're going to be happy for your brother getting married, for your brother making parnasa. If you remember that every Jew that you meet and every woman that you meet is your brothers and sisters, why do you have to be jealous? You cannot be, just the opposite. Sheismach besimchat chaveron, viitztaer betzar chaveron. When your friend is suffering, feel the pain. Azaria. When you're going out and your friend weddings, you have to dance because your brother getting married. You have to be happy for him. Do you hear that? If we remember that we all one family, where jealousy coming in from? And last but not least, the Shlach HaKadoshai. In order to kill negative jealousy, you have to create positive jealousy. You see that? You have to maneuver this jealousy that you already have in yourself and maneuver it to positive one. Meaning, instead of being jealous which shoes you're wearing, I will be jealous which masechet you finish. You hear that? Ah, Emmanuel, you're going out to the yeshiva and say, I don't care which shoes, I don't care which watch you have, AP, Shmei-P, I don't care which watch. I care that he have the ability to wake up every morning, 7:45 to Minyan. I wish I can be like him. I wish that I'm going to find the power and the will to wake up every morning and to come to speak to the Almighty God. What a privilege we have. You don't have to kill jealousy. Just recalculate it. How that way said, recalculate it, right? Recalculate it, meaning you make a mistake, what do you have to do? Don't go back all the way home. Just go to another path. And another path, Yosef, is finding a positive jealousy. You see, a person that gives in charity, be jealous. Why you cannot give like him? I wish that I can help the world much greater. You see, a person organized Shiur Torah, be jealous of him. I wish that this Shiur Torah can be in my house. Not because I don't want it to be in his house. I want it to be in his house and also in my house. I want the Kedusha to come to my house. Try to find what Chazal said, Kinat Sofrim Tarbe Chochma. Do you know why it's so important to speak about it? Because I will tell you, what did I say today? Ayudi HaKadosh, the holy Jew said, the holy Jew from Fashishcha writes, last week parasha and this week, but last week parasha, come Yaakov Avinu and called the children. And what did the Pasuk said? Easfu ve'agid alachem et asher ikre etchem be'acharit ha'amim. Dr. Michael, come closer. All my children, come together, come together. And I will tell you what's going to happen in the end of days. How many war, World War III, Milchemet Gog and Magog, whatever rabbi like to speak. I will tell you exactly what's going to happen. This is the simple explanation. Miron, listen to the deep explanation, Eli. Do you know what the Yehudi HaKadosh, the Holy Jew writes? The Holy Jew writes, no. You know what Yaakov is telling the children? In the end of days, we're going to have a lot of suffering, a lot of obstacles. COVID-19, now we have the new version. Economy is crisis. Health is scary. I mean, you know, how many of us got stuck in the house? And Patiel, what do we have to do? What do we have to do to overcome all the challenges? Come Yaakov Avinu and tell their own children, I will give you a secret. How can you overcome every obstacle in life, even the worst obstacle that's going to happen in the end of days? You don't understand how scary. It's only the beginning. If God forbid there's going to be a war between the two greatest nations right now, or three of them, Russia, China, and America, you know what? The whole world is going to collapse. And it's not far, God forbid. The whole world is shaky right now. The whole world is scared. What exactly do you have to do when, God forbid, we're going to get to a situation that everything is going to be crisis? What do you have to do? Come, Yaakov Avinu said, "Easfu ve'agida." Come together. Because when you're together, you can overcome every obstacle. No obstacle will ever touch you. If you love every Jew, if you don't have one Jew that you hate, if you're with unity and achdut, if you don't come in to rebuke, you don't put tefillin, you don't know what's in Shabbat, you're going to go to Gehenam, you don't eat kosher. Each one of us become a rabbi. 2 days ago, we didn't. None of us skipped Torah mitzvot. 2 days later, we come in to rebuke. Come the Yehudi HaKadosh and said, if you go in with the attitude that every Jew is better from you, automatically you're not going to rebuke nobody. It's not my job to tell you how to be righteous. My job is to invite you to Shiur Torah. That's it. This is my job. Come with me. That's it. Let the Shiur Torah do the rest. But Zechariah, you hear that? If you're not going to have one person that you hate, you're going to be saved from the end of time. E'asfu ve'agid alachem. Come together and I will tell you how to overcome the obstacle of the end of days. What an explanation, huh? Yosef, can you hear such explanation in Long Island? You're coming all the way to Queens to hear something that is very rare, almost impossible to hear in any other place. You know what the secret of success? Do you want to get married fast? Do you want to have unlimited wealth? Do you want to be successful in the yeshiva studies? And anything you choose, what do you have to do? Ask for. Come together. Come with unity. Take away the jealousy, take away the anger, take away all this negativity that putting us apart. By the way, I was thinking today, this is might be the reason of COVID-19. I'm not a prophet of God, and I don't want to justify any punishment. But God always pay measure to measure. And God always punish measure to measure. Do you know what's the punishment of a person that speaks Lashon Hara? A person that speaks bad on his friends. They call it in English or in Arabic or in Bukharian, Janganuzi. What's the punishment of a person that speaks Lashon Hara? Do you know the punishment? What's the punishment? He became the old time, in the time of the Bible. He used to have what? Leprosy. And what is the halakha, what's the rule with a person with leprosy? He has to go outside of the camp. Nobody can be next to him. Even one leprosy with another leprosy cannot sit. They have to be far. And what's the reason? What's the reason? What's the connection? I will tell you. What is the cost of Lashon Hara? The cost of Lashon Hara is to take two friends, two partners, a husband and wife, and to make a little balagan and to put them apart. To create distance, right? Bad speech. Janganuzi create division among people. God said, measure to measure. You create division, I will put you outside. Because you have to remember what you did. You took two people that love each other and you made them go apart. Is this punishment remind you something in our generation? COVID-19. What exactly we do in COVID-19? You cannot be next to your wife. You cannot be next to your children. Even two people with COVID-19 have to be far away from each other. You are in the basement when your wife sends you a food like this, like 70 years ago, you know, with the ropes, a little soup. This is what you have to eat. You're going like a zombie. You don't wake up in the morning. You don't go to sleep at night. You don't understand. What's the reason? Measure to measure. You put people apart. God forbid. God remind us that all this reason of this sickness is to remind us as fuvagida, come together, have unity, judge any person in a favor eyes. But you're going to ask me, how can I do it? How can I judge in a favor eyes? And this is the topic of tonight. They call it Efrat. Efrat meaning in Hebrew, Aleph, Pei, Resh, Taf. You see, I will tell you first of all, three short stories and then we're going to get in. And then you understand the concept. The first story is, a husband used to come late every day. A man used to come late every day to the job. Dr. Daniel, if somebody or one of your workers come in late every day, I mean, one day you can close your eyes, second day, every day he come late. What exactly are you going to have? You're going to judge him in a negative? And then you're going to explain why he's doing it. He's a lazy bum. You're going to get angry with him. And then either you're going to fire him, or either you're going to give them, how do you call it? Not condition. Warning. Warning, penalty, warning. Listen, you cannot continue. The guy used to come every day late. After half an hour, the boss came to him and said, Moshele, better off, you're going to have a good explanation. He said, yes, I have an amazing explanation. You know why every morning I'm coming late? They have a woman with 5 children that have nobody in this world. She have nobody to take the children. She have no food in the tables, no one to clean the house. And every morning I'm going into her house and I'm helping this woman to cook, to make laundry, and to take the children to the schools. The boss looked at him and he was so ashamed. He started crying. He said, I suspect this guy for 6 months that he's a lazy bum. And the boss said after that, can I help you? He said, definitely. Can I take at least one of the children to the yeshiva? I also want to be a part, right? What a beautiful story. He said, yes. He said, what's the address? He said, the address is 6628 Santa Street. He said, this is not your house? He said, yes. My wife, I have 5 children, and I'm the only one that can help. What, he was wrong? Why suddenly when you become your wife is mad? How can you do it? I'm going to fire you. A regular woman, a different woman? Wow, you are a tzaddik. What about your wife? This is the first story. Second story, especially for the young guys. What's your name? Zachariah. And Daniel? Daniel, yes. Daniel, listen to this. Imagine yourself you don't get paid in a job that you work in for 3 years. After 3 years, you're coming in and you're asking to get paid, and the boss tell you, no money. Why? Somebody told me, Rabbi Vaknin, after 1 month, Kaddish at home. Which 3 years? 1 month you don't. The guy doesn't get paid, he come with gasoline. 3 years, day in, day out. And not only that, imagine yourself that you are married and you left your family all the way to Hong Kong in the old time with the boat, and you didn't get paid for 3 years. Wow. A story like that happened in the Gemara. A man that was working for 3 years. He came into the boss after 3 years and said, listen, I have to go back to my wife. Give me money. He said, no money. He said, okay, give me a field. This rich man had many fields. He said, give me field of tomato, cucumbers. He said, no field. He said, give me building. You have so many buildings. You own so many. He said, no buildings. He said, give me clothing. Give me pillow, blanket. Give me something. He said, I have nothing. The guy left. Wow. What a story. It's going to happen to us. Judge in the favor. We judge in the favor. Judge in the favor. Yosef, how many people you know is going to judge in the favor? You are Emmanuel, Emmanuel. 1 month later, the owner came, that boss came back, was driving all the way to his worker, and he gave the money. But before he gave him the money, he said, my dear son, when I told you I have no money, what came out to your mind? He said, I thought you invest all your money, all the cash, and other businesses. When I told you that I have no land, he said, I thought that the land and the building belong to the bank. So, I mean, it's not yours. One of them you rent and you have to get paid by rent, and the rent is going in to the mortgage. When I told you that I have no clothing, no pillow, no blanket, he said, I thought that you gave everything donation to Beit HaMikdash. He said, my dear son, this is exactly what's happened. The same way that you judge me in a favor eyes, the same way they're going to judge you in a favor eyes. He paid them double. He gave them gift. You don't understand. But you know who is this man that judged in a favor? His name is no other from Rabbi Akiva. The famous Rabbi Akiva that later on became the biggest rabbi in the world history. Now we understand why. What the leaven? You see that? This is what Efrat is all about. Efrat is the secret to succeed in life. How do you write Efrat? Aleph, Pei, Resh, Taf. Aleph, Pei, Resh, Taf is a secret in our life that being given, but this is a Jewish, this is from the Torah concept, but Alfred Adler, he is the one that revealed. A student of Sigmund Freud, one of his students that later on went ballistic against him, separate from Freud, and opened his own school. And he called it the method that called Efrat. What is Efrat? Efrat is Aleph, Irua. Irua meaning situation in life. What means situation? Situation meaning, God forbid you got fired. Somebody came late to the job. You had a flat tire, somebody scratched your car. Every item in your life is considered to be situation. They kicked you out from the yeshiva. Somebody, your parents got upset with you, or in any case, your father made a comment that you didn't like. A date that was canceled. And any, this is what we call situation. Aleph, Irua, situation. Bet, the pay, I'm sorry, Aleph, pay. Pay meaning Pirush, which explanation you give to the situation? Now, you cannot control the situation because situation is from God. But God gave you a gift to control the explanation. If I was instead of Rabbi Akiva, 3 years, no, nobody pay me, I'm not going to judge him in a favor. I'm going to judge him in Gehinnom. Maze Gehinne Gehinnom. I will open the oven. I will come with gasoline. Because automatically you're giving a bad explanation. The situation in life you cannot control. Somebody made a comment. You went into the neighbor and you asked for milk. She said, I don't have. Right away, you come back. This stingy, kamtsanit. You don't talk for 10 years. Why? Baby, she never had the milk. Because you gave bad explanation to the situation. Situation is out of our control. But the next one is in our control, explanation of the situation. Now, what explanation leads us to regesh? Regesh meaning emotion. If you give a good explanation, the emotion is positive. Now, Rabbi Akiva gave a good explanation, And then what exactly came? Wow, my boss lost all his money. Everything that he had belonged to the bank. He felt so much mercy on him. He didn't feel any anger. He didn't feel any jealousy. He didn't feel the wheel. Somebody is pushing you. And you said, I feel bad. Maybe his shoes was not good. He slept on me. Now, you come in and you help him. You give him a hug and a kiss. But most of us, if somebody is pushing us in the yeshiva, what do? Our explanation is, he did it on purpose. I'm going to show him. And then emotion is coming. And after emotion, reaction. You come to him and you give him, bam! That's it. Nobody will push me anymore. You see, instead of giving him a hug and a kiss, situation is not in our hand. It's in the hand of God. Explanation is what God gave us to control the situation that leads us to positive emotion. Your wife made a comment. Instead of blaming your wife, maybe you didn't understand. You see, it's all about how do you explain the situation to lead a positive. And then when we have the right emotion, the right reaction, buying the flowers and a gift. Your wife made a comment, and in the comment did, I feel lonely, you're never home, you're always walking. Now what are you gonna say? Your explanation to this, she's always complaining, she never see good, you know what, I feel bad, I'm doing this job only for you, to support you, what a low life, and then you build the hate. And for the next 3 weeks, the vacation to Bora Bora, or to, how do you call this place, the new place?
Dubai.
Cancel the trip. Kaddish Yetom on Dubai. Next, Lashana Abba. Now imagine yourself, the same situation, she made the same comment. And instead of being upset, so wow, she's so lonely. The child is still not arriving. She's lonely at home. Because of that, she made it. I feel the pain of my wife. You're coming back home. Now you gave a good explanation to the situation. Automatically, the emotion of mercy, the emotion of compassion is coming to the pictures. In Fridays, a beautiful bouquet of flowers. And you're staying the whole Shabbat at home. My wife, I love you. Now we're not only going to Dubai, we're going to, first of all, Israel and then Dubai. We're going to do a vacation because I feel that you need it. Do you see that? Efrat. Irua, Pirush, Regesh, and Teguva. In English, Efrat meaning situation, explanation, emotion, and reaction. The Almighty God will help all of us to give the right explanation that will lead us to the right emotion, that will finish with the best reaction. Thank you very much.